Have you ever noticed that it's hard to have eye contact during a video call? This is because people don't usually look into the camera during a call. Instead, they look at the other person's image on their display, or sometimes they even look at their own preview image. In a typical video conferencing setup, the camera and the display are not aligned with each other. This camera-display user geometry creates a gaze disparity that makes it hard to maintain eye contact and have a natural face-to-face conversation. We propose an eye contact correction model that restores the eye contact regardless of the relative position of the camera and display. Whether your camera is located at the top left, center, or right corners of your device, our model redirects the gaze from an arbitrary direction to the center, out of the box, without any calibration. Our system uses a deep convolutional neural network that redirects the gaze by warping and tuning the eyes in the input frames. To prevent this model from modifying the input images beyond repair, we trained it in a bidirectional way that enforced mapping reversibility. Our model learned how to move the gaze towards one direction and to revert it back to its original state to reconstruct the original input image simultaneously. This training setup reduced the artifacts and resulted in more natural eye contact correction. To train our model, we used millions of image pairs where a subject looked into two different directions in each pair. So where did we get all this data from? We generated a large portion of it synthetically. We used the generative adversarial network to refine the synthetic samples in our dataset. The refined synthetic samples looked virtually indistinguishable from the natural ones. Being able to generate photorealistic synthetic data allowed for generating an immense amount of perfectly labeled data at a minimal cost. An interesting phenomenon we observed is that our model learned to predict the input gaze as a side product at no additional cost. In this demo video, for example, the circle shows where the model thinks that the user is looking at. This behavior is likely a byproduct of training the model without explicitly providing a redirection angle. The model simply infers the input gaze to be able to move it to the center. We didn't train this model to be a fully blown gaze predictor, so it shouldn't be expected to be as accurate as systems that are designed particularly for that purpose. It's an interesting observation, though, that our model learned the input gaze implicitly to function better as an eye contact corrector. We use a set of control mechanisms that prevent creepy results and ensure a smooth and natural video conferencing experience. Those mechanisms control the strength of correction, prevent creepiness from overly corrected eye contact, and ensure temporal consistency in live applications. For example, we smoothly disable correction when user is blinking or clearly looking at somewhere other than the camera and the display. Overall, the control mechanisms prevent abrupt changes and ensure that the eye contact corrector avoids doing any unnatural correction. Our eye contact corrector runs in real time and supports a wide variety of video conferencing capable devices, having different display sizes and camera placements. Our model preserves details such as glasses and eyelashes without hallucinating details that do not exist in the input. We built this system primarily to improve the quality of video conferencing experience. However, it can be used in other cases too. For example, personal broadcasters can read a script from the display of their device while maintaining eye contact with their viewers. Take a look at our paper to learn more about how our system works.